So I guess you can hear me now. So fine, thanks Manoj for the introduction and also the organizer for giving us this exposure to showcase our work here. So I am from IMSC, but the work I'm going to share has been done at Essenbos Center a couple of years back. However, now this is going to be old wine in a new bottle. Let us proceed. So I'm going to talk about a phenomena which is very ubiquitous in nature. That's the phenomena of lane formation, where two species of particles are driven against each other. So it's a classic example of slipstreaming, which has been seen in army ants, pedestrian dynamics, many, many systems. So that's why this system is generally considered as a model pattern forming system away from equilibrium. And one of the very simple relation that could be, that the similar kind of experiment could be done in experiments is using these charge colloidal systems. So what happens when we have a binary mixture of opposite charges, we have a system of binary mixture of opposite charges under electric field. It forms local domains of like charges and it flows. So we expect a phase separation here, and here this phase separation happens, but happens in this is a microphase separation. We have a domain of like charges that is flowing in a direction, and the other species goes the other way. So it's a slip streaming. So, and that's the instability. So a single problem, which would be very relevant in understanding many deep. That's why we have taken, and what happens beyond the critical stress, beyond a critical field, shows laning. And for different field strengths, it shows different pattern. And so what happens along the field, so it shows strips like this of opposite charges. And in the transverse direction, there are patterns of like charges. And this was actually predicted before the experiments were validated. So experiments validated in 2005, and this was the theoretical prediction where this phenomena and all the some of the very earlier predictions were given. And so we analyze and just because there is a slip streaming motion, so there is a symmetry breaking here that we have also affirmed. And what happens, the direction, so the dynamics along the field and dynamics transverse to the field is not the same. So, and also the same, the follow-up experiments from the earlier group have also shown that there is a dynamic heterogeneity in the system, which also we have verified. So it's now this problem gives a scope to explore dynamic heterogeneity in a liquid state. So basically, we are far away from these glassy packings, and also this is a driven situation where we have also shown this kind of exponential tails is very, very commonly glassy systems where these patterns are for higher field strength. We have there existing class of different kind of dynamics that happens. But the earlier works that we have now, this dynamic heterogeneity, as in very simple words, it says that it's nothing but the simultaneous flow and fast. So what we are now interested understand whether this low and fast particle has got any patterns or not. And if there are, how do these patterns are going to sustain? So we are keen to understand. So we are trying to identify this hidden pattern, means we try to explore this hidden order between these low and fast particles in the system. So this is one typical case. So these are the transverse motion during this lane formation, and here. So now this is for one particular charge. So in the white portion, the other charge resides. Now you can see, first of all, these patterns do not only evolves, however, they also rearrange, keeping the same laning tendency in the system. So even though the system has reached a steady lane state, the patterns do not show any steady behavior. So patterns also evolve among themselves. So now we try to understand what happens to these slow and fast particles and how do they contribute in the formation of these patterns. So and first, so there since the patterns evolves, so there must be an interplay between the slow and fast particles. And what we have seen that the slow and fast particles do also exchange their identities dynamically. So at some times, at some time interval, a slow particle can become a fast particle at some other instant, and vice versa. So what we are looking at to look at the spatiotemporal correlation between the slow and fast particles. So we ask very two simple questions. So how long they are going to be fast and how far they are going to be correlated? And how long and how far they are going to be correlated spatiotemporally? So for to answer these questions, what we have to do, first very simple task is to instantaneous detection of the slow and fast particles. So this is a very difficult task. So just because this slow and fast exchange their identities, so one of the very so since I'm not smart enough, so that's why I have to rely on the machine. So we did a very simple things of machine learning. So what we did, we trained the machine so that they can, so the machine has got some rules to identify slow and fast particles. And that's a very simple way. When these patterns are forming, every time it actually compares the single particle mean square displacement with respect to the bulk behavior. And if the single particle displacement is larger than the maximally probable displacement at the same time instant, it says it's fast or else it's slow. If it's slower than that, it's slow. But however, these rules are not unique. One can actually change these rules to identify different order different order informations. And so this is the very first task that we show. So this is one typical case where this we show the evolution of the patterns in different for different field strengths. And now this is for the length state where we have this network like patterns. We differently show the evolution of the slow and fast particles. So it shows, so this anime, this movies show that there exist a correlation between the slow and fast particles. So even for the slow charges, you have this pattern. Also for the fast particle, it has got that pattern. Although the rate at which they are changing is not the same. So and what if we project them together? And it shows that the full learning patterns for a particular charge that we obtain. This is for one typical case. And now we ask, how does the slow and fast particles relax around each other to identify or to explore the time scale of relaxation of these individual slow and fast particles? So there, since in our system we have binary mixture, so basically two different charges, and out of them there could be slow and fast particles. So total number of possible combination of these structures are 12, and out of them, if we focus on a particular charge, the combination decreases to 6. So here we show how this structural relaxation of these slow and fast particles is changing with respect to different field strengths. So how does it is actually, I have shown for few typical cases, all 12 combinations are not there. And from the instant, from the decay of this this correlation, so we have looked into the distinct Van Hoffs. So it gives the structural relaxation between any two particles. And from there we identify the time scale and see how does this time scale change for each of the species and for each of the field strengths. So these are the time scales. So what it shows that it has got a distinct relaxation time scale for each of the combinations, which also changes with the field strength. And the heterogeneity, we have shown that the heterogeneity of this simultaneous relaxation of these particular structures is maximum, where we earlier shown that the heterogeneity in diffusion was maximum. And also we address the so this was for the steady state. In the transient regime, we have also identified how the length scale of these slow and fast particles are changing. So it shows that the slow particles actually contribute more in this pattern formation. With this, I am going to stop. And this is a so this was a quite an abstract motif, and a literature came only a few months back, so has got similar kind of ideas sensed. So with this thing, I want to thank you for your attention.
Questions.
To identify the fast and slow particles, instead of looking at the mean square displacement, why don't you look at the instantaneous velocities?
That is also possible. For our case, we were using this Brownian dynamics, so velocity was overdamped. So that's why we went for. So any other thing could be. So velocity is also be one option.
Are you looking at the mean square displacement over a long period of time? Or?
No. You have to look for some intervals, and within that interval, we have to identify. Because in you are absolutely correct. Because in another problem, we have actually cross checked this thing in the velocity space as well. So which I can we can discuss sometime.
So if there are no questions, let's thank Suman.